Hello, everyone. In this video, we'll introduce the linearly interpolate actions available in GDevelop. These actions become available for 3D objects and cameras once you import the Advanced 3D Features extension. There are three types of linearly interpolate actions. First, linearly interpolate 3D object. Second, linearly interpolate toward child of 3D object. And third, linearly interpolate camera. These are useful when you want to make a camera or object follow another object smoothly. Let's look at the specific use cases one by one. Use case 1. Set to the same position and angle. First, let's cover the most basic usage. This is used when you want to move an object or camera to the exact same position and angle as another object. Of course, you can achieve this without using linearly interpolate. But the linearly interpolate 3D object action provides a simpler way to get the same result. The key is to set the position interpolation factor and rotation interpolation factor to 1. These represent the ratio of how much to move toward the target. A value of 0 means no change at all, while 1 means it will move to the exact same position and angle. Use case 2. Approach gradually. Previously, we set the factor to 1. But by setting this value to less than 1, you can smooth out the movement. For example, a factor of 0.5 means it will move halfway toward the target. In this example, the linearly interpolate 3D object action is executed every frame while the mouse is held down, causing the object to approach smoothly. Use case 3, following. In actual games, you rarely just move something to the exact same position. More often, you'll adjust the relative position and angle from that point to create a following behavior. In this example, after moving the particle to the enemy's position and angle, relative rotation and movement are added to make the particle follow the area around the enemy's broken horn. This is a technique often used with the linearly interpolate camera action when you want to make a camera follow an object without using the existing camera behaviors. Use case 4. Following smoothly. This is an application of use case 3, following. In this example, the particle is made to follow smoothly by setting the position interpolation factor to 0.02 and the rotation interpolation factor to 0.05, relative to the enemy. The important point is that the relative rotation and movement amounts also need to be adjusted in accordance with the interpolation factors. In this example, the relative rotation and movement amounts are also scaled by these same factors. This technique is also often used for camera following, just like in use case 3. Use case 5. Spawning from a relative position. This is also an application of use case 3. In this example, when a particle is created, it is first moved to the same position and angle as a spaceship, and then it is moved to the relative position of the muzzle. This makes it appear as if the particle is being fired from the muzzle. Use case 6. Attaching to a child's position. When a 3D model animates, the point you want to attach something to might change its position. For example, when you want a character to hold something in their hand, that hand's position will be moving. In such cases, you use the linearly interpolate toward child of 3D object action. This action has a parameter called target child name. You need to find the child's name beforehand using the output children hierarchy action or your 3D modeling tool. In this example, we know the enemy has a child named Hand Slaughter, so we move the sword to that child's position and angle, and then adjust its relative position to make the character hold the sword. The linearly interpolate action is very useful, not only for making objects and cameras follow targets, but also as a starting point for relative movements and rotations. Give it a try in your own game.